Hey, you! Yeah, talk. Bitch! Yes, listen, man. Are you trying to get better at NBA 2K18? Well, listen up, man. I got some tips and tricks for you, bro. You pay attention, you can be the greatest player on this fucking game!
Alright, man, step number one, the first thing you want to learn if you want to craft yourself into the greatest NBA 2K player is you want to learn. Now, this is very technical detail here. Now, it takes a lot of skill to pull this off. Now, some may refer to it as zigzag cheese, but me, I like to refer to it as tactical horizontal movement. When you're trying to apply tactical horizontal movement, you want to move your left stick left and right, and then left one more time and right. In a very strategic formula. This works against any build, and even the best players do it. In fact, I heard from a little birdie that if you're a shot creator, this is all you have to really do. Tactical horizontal movement is best used when there's a horde of Hall of Fame brick wall screens to help you out. Once you combine those two very complicated but effective strategies, you will begin to dominate folks on NBA 2K18. Number two is probably the most difficult animation you can ever get in the game. But if you do get it, it will result in automatic buckets. So you gotta learn how to get it, right? Now the best of the best get this all the time. The newbies, never. It's just too complicated for them. This move, although some might refer to it as a snatchback, I call it the force field atomic separator. Now, when you're trying to pull off the force field atomic separator, what you want to do is run into your opponent like this. Do you guys see how close I am to you? Do you feel me? In fact, my hat is currently hitting the mic. You guys hear the additional noise. Now, as you run into your opponent, you want to do one thing. Take the right stick and pull it down. As you do that, the force field atomic separator will get set into action. Now, once it gets set into action, it's almost guaranteed space. But it's way too challenging to hit those mid-range shots on NBA 2K18, so don't settle for that. Get a dunk. You can then drive to the hoop, run into the opponent once again, and as you're running, you will get 2 points. You can do this at any time with any player against even the toughest of lockdown defenders. The force field atomic separator is one of the deadliest moves in the game, but you have to do it and know when to do it. And to know when to do it, you just have to do it every time because it will work every time. This works really well when you're running a 5-out offense and you're spacing the floor so that when the force field atomic separator goes into action, there's nobody to help out. You'll take a lot of practice though. Clicking down on the right stick to get such a phenomenal move, it takes so much skill that honestly, the people that do get it down have a really good advantage. The next move I'm gonna be talking about, some might refer to as a blow-by animation. I call it something different. I call it the friction lubricator. Anytime you're bumping up against somebody, listen, this is all you gotta do. Forget a dribble move. You will never in your life have to do left, left, boom, 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 boom. You'll never have to do that. Nope. Unnecessary. Listen, all you really have to do is just run into your opponent. Did you see what I did there? As you run into your opponent, the friction lubricator will take action, and just as you start to hit your opponent, you'll just slide off of him and run right by him and find yourself open for a bucket. Now, if you happen to be a slasher, a playmaker, a shot creator, a sharpshooter, did I miss any archetypes? This works very effectively for you, man. And I know it seems like a challenging thing to do, to just walk into the opponents, but I'm telling you, once you get it down, you'll be straight. I feel like I'm doing the community a solid here. Like, I'm just giving out all the secrets, you know? You see all the best players do these tricks, and you're thinking, Agent, could you just share some tips to help me win these games? And I'm telling you, man, I know it's hard. I know these moves is a high skills gap, we know. But hey, I'm here to help the community. That's what I do. Now, this one here is a little bit of a low-key one, but again, takes a lot of skill to accomplish. Now, only the best of the best do this, right? You want to have a big man, preferably an athletic finisher, but it could also be a glass cleaner. In fact, if you're doing the move, you can be anybody. You want to, this, I know, pay attention. You want to hold circle in the paint in the restricted area so they can't box you out. And if they can't box you out, you have perfect positioning. And unless the guy guarding you is a lockdown defender, by doing just a complicated process of holding circle in the paint, you can get yourself open for a bucket. I know what you're thinking, Agent. It's hard to do, I'm telling you. But just hustle. jostle, fight your way into the restricted area. The second you get under the paint, hold circle. Hold it. And once you hold it, they can't push you out of it. I mean, unless you get three in the key. But just get your point guard to kick it into you, and boom. You just figured out how to do one of the more complicated plays in NBA 2K18. I'm trying to introduce tactics to the game that require skill. And I know some people just like a super easy game, right? Without Vobiana. Okay. But god damn it if I don't do my part. Yeah, how's there a squirrel outside, bro? I promise you it's like minus 20 Celsius right now. A man can't be frozen? Come on, even I don't want to go outside, bro. There we go, people. I never want to hear you ask for another tip ever again, all right? If you guys enjoy, man, drop a like, subscribe. If you guys are new, listen, I upload 2K18 videos all the time, all right? So subscribe. Do yourself a favor. Yo, it's cold out, so I've just been at home, man. I promise you, I'm not going to go outside in this weather. It just won't happen. Yesterday, I was driving. My car's brakes just stopped working. It happened twice. Once when I was driving back out of the driveway. Do I know English? In a second, I was dead ass going into an intersection and the brakes was like, nah, I'm good. So I'm staying my ass indoors, which means I guess I'll be playing 2K and editing videos all day.
Jokes!
Black Mirror season 4, baby. What you thought? I'm out of here. I'll catch you guys later. Peace.